guys?
Oh, we were on the half. We were on the headsets at halftime when we first came out, and that's when that was the first time I had heard it that he was out and wasn't coming back. Did it change anything? No, probably a little bit more. We didn't pressure as much. Just because of the athleticism of Boyd, we didn't pressure him as much and stayed in zone and said, let's just keep the ball in front of him. And if they're going to beat us, let's make him prove that he can stand in the pocket and throw the ball and beat us. And let's not give up the cheap play or the athletic play by turning and creating pressure and letting that athlete get out on the perimeter.
Skip, you said late in the season that, you know, some of the close conference losses, some of your guys, you know, it might be one of the seasons where you go, what if? Given, except for maybe the last 2 minutes today, right. Is this how you wanted to end the season on both sides of the ball, looking forward?
Outside of the last 2 minutes, without a doubt. And outside of the last 2 minutes, I told Will I hope we helped the ratings today by keeping it close. But, you know, this really was a complete game. I don't think we kicked the ball on special teams as well as I'd like to. We missed a field goal, kicked the ball out of bounds once, didn't punt the ball particularly well. But I thought the cover teams, the return teams, the offense, the defense, complete team win, created a couple turnovers. Defense answered the challenge when we put the ball on the ground twice as an offense. They answered the challenge. I thought it was a total team win. And the thing was, we got into this bowl game, we didn't change a thing. We didn't put in a play, we didn't put in a formation. We didn't change a thing. We just said, we're gonna keep doing what we do and we're gonna try and just keep getting better at it. And that's a real tribute to these players.
Skip, I want to ask you, after the change of momentum right before halftime, that first drive of the second half, I think you converted 3 third downs. Just how big was that to keep them from getting any closer than they got?
I think BJ had an awful lot to do with that, with his legs and getting away from pressure a couple times. Times I thought the throw that he made to Kevin Guidry, although it was a little bit ill-advised, back across his body over the middle of the field, rolling to his right, although it was a little ill-advised, he stuck it in there between about four white jerseys, and Kevin Guidry made a great diving catch. But that was part of why we said we were going with BJ, because he was really in tune to the game, and he was going to give us the ability to turn and make some things happen with his feet when things broke down. And I thought he did a great job of that. I thought he did a great job of managing the game, taking what the defense gave him, and I thought he really BJ was a quarterback today.
BJ, for a season for you that's had some pretty highs and lows, what does it feel like to finish on this note?
It's a blessing. You know, I'm just thankful and happy to be here. And you know, the thing about it is these coaches have really put a lot of confidence in me, and they've helped me out every step of the way. So it means a lot to finish the season, you know, like this.
BJ, can you talk just about getting past that early interception, but staying within, you know, keeping your confidence and going through the game the rest of the way?
Yeah, you know, that was kind of rough. You know, I felt like Bogan caught it, you know, but, you know, it happened. And, you know, after that, there was nothing I could do about it. You know, take it and try to move on and just improve and get better with it.
BJ, when did you find out you were a start? Do you remember when he told you?
Right before the game, right before it started.
The confidence, I mean, you've had games where you've gone through and had picks and come back. To not get rattled at all and to know that coach has confidence in you, how much did that help?
It helps out a lot. You know, we have guys, you know, like my teammates and these coaches behind me. It really does help out a lot. You have a supporting staff, and, you know, it, like I said, it just really is a blessing. I'm just thankful.